So I want to flash back again. I'm going to go back in time.
Yeah.
You've got this idea. You've got this aha. And you, I understand you jumped on your bike and rode over to Vinod Khosla's office.
Jumped on it.
That's what, well, okay. You got on your bike. Okay.
Yeah.
You sort of, I'm visualizing this. Okay. You're like, oh my gosh, I'm going to drive over to Vinod Khosla's office and show him my pitch deck. And you walked out with $7 million.
Yes, roughly, yeah.
Roughly.
So
okay.
in that
so
ballpark.
So what did you say to him?
Yeah, suitcase full of money, basically.
What did you say to him? And what was it that got him so excited that he said, okay, I got to do this?
What can we
learn from you?
I don't want to speak for Vinod. He might give a different answer for what it was. I mean, basically, what I said to him was, and I should say for business people here, the pitch that I gave him in retrospect was ridiculous, because it was because I had never been in the business world. I had no experience with this kind of stuff, and I had been introduced to Vinod by a scientist friend of mine, who said, "Oh, Vinod will be very interested in this project," and blah blah blah. So I basically most of my presentation was about how hugely important this problem was to solve of we have to find a better technology than animals for producing these foods because it's so insanely destructive. And I absolutely believe it can be done, and I have some sketchy ideas about how it might be done if you give me the money. And oh, by the way, the global market for these products is $1.5 trillion. And ever since then, I say this, but it's not a joke, it's true, that final slide gets closer to the front of the deck as I learn more and more about how business works.